Hi, I'm here for another screen recording on how to use Weebly. A tutorial on how to use Weebly. So I'm going to show you guys how to use the store. The store thing that you can use. Okay, sorry. Okay, there we go. So when I showed the settings video, it had some store stuff, but it didn't have all these things that you could use. Alright, so this is the dashboard first. So you can view your store right here. Add a store page. A store page helps to organize all of your products. So you could press add, but I don't want to. So number two, add products. Add or import products to your store. So you press add. And then number three, add store information. This information will appear on invoices to customers. You press add. And then accept payments is number four. And you choose how to collect money from customers. And you press edit for that one. Okay, so then this is the products. Oops, sorry. You just add a product or import a product. As you see, I don't have any products because I don't run a store. You'd press add product. Sorry, it's loading. And this is a name, a short description. Sorry. Okay. A short description. The product type, physical good, price, sale price, SKU, I don't know what that is, it's optional, and so is the weight. And you would drag an image here if you want people to know like what it looks like. And that's the products. So it's a storefront. So you can view your storefront, and it shows all your products. So I think you need to have some products to use this, and then your page layout, like what you use to edit in pages, sort of like that. And then you'd have to press update changes when you're all done with that. And then this is category, so add a category. So like you would put a category for like each different thing if you wanted to, but obviously you don't have to. But I would think you'd need products. I just don't really know. And then this is orders. And it's basically like orders. Like you're giving people like what they wanted. So it gives you the order number, order date, the customer, the status, and the total. Once your store receives an order, it will display here. So that's kind of nice for store owners. Then here is settings. As you see, there's a lot more things in settings. And you probably would want it. It's like the currency, the weight unit, and the store mode. Most people, I think, would use US dollars for Weebly. I don't know, but this is you'd pick your money, euros, pounds, all that. The weight unit, imperial, pound, inch. Metric, so you'd probably it'd either be metric system or imperial system. And then the store mode, it's like what when somebody wants to buy something, you would press add to cart, or you could do buy now. And then you have to give your store information. Your company name, the street, the city, the postal zip code, the postal / zip code, country, state, province, customer support email, and your phone number, and then the store policies. This will appear on your cart and checkout pages. So, let me see what this is. I don't actually really get what that is, but shipping policy, Oh, it's just your policies, like for your returning, like presents or something like that. It's like that. And then this is shipping for like shipping. Then checkout. So it says accept payments. This is primary way for customers to pay. Start accepting credit cards instantly. Integrated checkout on your site, 2.9% plus 30 cents per transition. So you would connect to one of those credit card things or something like that. Alternative payment providers, checkout with PayPal. Don't know what that is. It's easy to sign up and connect, and I think you could press on this. See what it brings you to. And you can use PayPal if you want to. And it looks like it's owned by Weebly, I guess. But I don't know. It redirects to PayPal for checkout. 2.9% plus 30 cents per transition. And then you press connect. And authorize.net is probably something like that. Merchant account application required. Integrated checkout on your site. Fees depend on merchant account. So that's some of that. And then that's the checkout section. And you had to have to press connect. So I don't want to press connect because I don't know what it will do. And then, so this is a display. I think it's like how it will look. Display options, store layout. Set the store layouts. Columns of categories, columns of products on storefront, products per page. 36. I guess you could have less or more if you want to. Image ratios. Set the image ratios. Product image, default, or you could pick whatever you want. Category image, like the same thing. Legacy mode. Enable legacy mode to switch back to the old product element design. Legacy mode. Let's see what this is. Oh, it doesn't. Oh, there we go. Huh? Nothing. I'll just turn that back off because I don't know what it does. Then shipping. I think that'll be okay, right? Upgrade required. So you must upgrade to the business package to use shipping settings. So you need to have it's sort of like pro for Weebly. I don't know how much that would cost. Let's see. So I'll bring up this another window. Oh, I think this is just to verify your account, enter the telephone number and retrieve a verification code that we send you via SMS. Okay, so you just have to do that. And I don't know how much it'd pay for, but also, I can't look at that, so I can't really tell you what that is. So let's go to taxes. Yeah, it does the same thing. You must upgrade to the business package to use tax settings. But by the way, it looks in the background, it looks like it's taxes, like paying your taxes, but I don't obviously know. All right, so that was all the settings for store, and I hope this video has helped you, so thank you.